Hi everybody, this is Sifu Jensen, and today I'd like to talk to you about using your legs and your body mechanics to power up your hand techniques in tantoi or springy legs. And tantoi or springy legs, or spring steel legs as I like to call it, is one of the most famous kung fu forms that there is. There's a number of variations of this form. It's a long form with at least 10, or the version that we practice, 12 different lines. I learned tantoi from my teacher, Grandmaster Wang Jackman, and this is the Jing Wu version, the Jing Wu lineage of the tantoi form. And tantoi, usually people think about it as a real strength and endurance building form. You're doing a lot of stances. It's repetitive with 12 lines of techniques that you're training, really training the horse stance and the bow and arrow stance, and how to transition from a horse stance to a bow and arrow stance, and from a bow and arrow stance back to a horse stance, and then use that transition to develop power. And I judge a lot of tournaments, and I'm out in the martial arts scene watching a lot of our current generation of kung fu practitioners. And many people, a place that they can level up their technique, level up their performance, and really get into sort of the old school method of doing kung fu, is to concentrate on really using your stances to develop the power of your striking techniques. And frequently, I see people, they'll do a stance, and then their arms are really separate. There's no real connection between the arms and the stance. But what we want to do is use the transition, the movement of the center mass of our body, the center of our body, moving that mass as a way to power up our hand techniques and make our hand techniques have the power of our whole body and give them a lot more strength. So in tantoi, I'm going to show you two of the break grab techniques that are in tantoi and how we're using our stance and our legs to help make these break grab techniques work. The first line of tantoi has two break grab techniques that I think are practical and useful, and they are really great to start learning how to use your whole body and your body weight to generate some force. So the very first one is in response to our first punch if someone had grabbed us. So at this point, I'm in a deep bow and arrow stance and I've punched out. And if Sean were able to grab my wrist at this point, I'm going to do a couple of things. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn my wrist over. And as I do that, I'm usually going to also turn my rear foot out and grip the ground with my rear foot and get ready to pull with my rear leg. So I've turned my hand over. Turning my hand over lines my radius, the bone of my forearm here, up between the gap of the fingers and the thumb. So this is helping to loosen his grip and to fine-tune me to the easiest way to escape his grip, which is right between the gap here. Now, instead of just pulling with my hand or pulling with my arm muscles, I'm gonna very quickly sink the center mass of my body backward, dropping my entire body backward suddenly. And that's much, much, much harder to hold onto for him than if I'm to struggle with him or to fight his strength with my strength. And if the other person is much larger than you and they're very, very strong, you may not be able to overpower them with your arm strength. But if you learn how to essentially toss all of the weight of your body backward and then sink down, and you sit down into your low stance, using the power of your low stances, you're moving suddenly very far away from the other person, and all of the weight of their body is trying to hold on to something leaping between this grip. So it's a very simple, but very powerful technique. And it's sort of, you have to have a little bit of feeling of falling to get the speed going. And you also want to use your rear foot to pull a little bit. So let's take a look one more time. I'm here, I'm punching. I'm turning my rear foot out, positioning my ankle and my hip, my knee and the rear leg. I'm turning my foot, my hand over, loosening his grip, lining up my forearm to go out between them, and I'm going to suddenly drop into my horse. One thing I like to do is leaving my elbow up. This is the classic position, but if he's falling forward or charges you, he can run into your elbow. So that's nice, having the elbow up there firmly pointed outward. So this is your first break grab technique from Tan Tui. Have a great time practicing it.